Salutations to the sun. Hail Helios and Vesta. Hail Alpha and Omega. Hail great central sun magnet. Hail keepers of the flame of the sun in the earth. I am Prince Oromasis, and this is my beloved consort, Diana. Receive us now as the rainbow fire of our hearts leaps into your own. Won't you be seated, most gracious ones? Wherever there is fire, there we abide. We reside in the center of the sun, in the heart of I am that I am, in the heart of your threefold flame, and in the nucleus of every atom in the earth. Think then, how God has returned to this evolution, the fire element, and from that element all civilization has proceeded. So the fire quickens the mind, quickens the spirit, warms the soul, and clothes her with the etheric garment of living fire. Behold the salamanders, whose height is very great. Behold them as the rainbow rays of God and white fire and colors you have never seen before do pulsate round them and continuously. Behold the great adepts of fire, who are the alchemists among alchemists, who have taught the ancient alchemists and to perform that alchemy daily. We are a part of all of the processes of life. We then, in the heart of life, go forth from that point, and we, knowing at the levels of our attainment, for we are ascended master hierarchs, and those whom we have raised to that level, who are the salamanders who have mastery of the etheric octave, we then move together in precision, and we are there for the consuming of that which ought to be consumed, and for the firing of that which must remain permanent. How is it then that the same fire of Shiva can destroy and can sustain? Fire makes permanent, fire neutralizes and erases that which was never meant to be. So the beauty of fire, beloved, is that it is the focal point for all alchemy of all elementals, angels, and mankind. Thus we would see, by rainbow fire, as you may call our fire, by violet flame, by intensification of sacred fire of the mother itself, of the white fire containing all, we would see transmuted and erased the burdens upon elemental life. We would see the burdens erased from round about yourselves also. We would see the clearing of time and space. We would see the clearing of this entire dedicated property. You see, beloved ones, you have a source. We may dip into that source. It is your threefold flame. It is your Holy Christ flame in your Holy Christ self. It is the same mighty threefold flame in the heart of your I Am Presence. At these several levels of being, and then continuing as the fire of the chakras and the fire of ascension current that begins as kundalini fire and increases until the hour of your ascension. All these are points of fire in your being. Consider them the nucleus of every cell. Consider the energy that the body produces. All of this translates to heat, to life, to eternal life, and to victory. When you think of these resources within yourself and you look upon elemental life, you can understand why the need of the hour is so urgent to liberate them from the burdens of world karma, mankind's karma, first and foremost, of the abuses of the four lower bodies representing the four elements. The misuse then of these elements and the consequent burden upon the elementals is precisely why you have gathered in this place at this altitude and level of purity, where there is a spiritual purity and an etheric retreat superimposed upon the physical manifestation. This is rare, beloved, but here it is established, and thus you walk on ground that is consecrated, which you yourselves may render holy by the holiness of your consciousness. We then propose to you a methodical and planned action, be it 5 minutes or 15 minutes a day. It need not be long, but it must be regular. And I ask you to offer then this prayer. Beloved mighty I Am Presence, in the name of my Holy Christ Self, and by the love, wisdom, and power of my threefold flame, I call forth the action of transmutation by the fire of my being, multiplied by the violet flame, multiplied by the fire of the great central sun and the great central sun magnet. I call forth this action on behalf of all elemental life, including my body elemental, the body elementals of all souls evolving on planet Earth. I call for that portion of the flame I invoke and all that I am to go forth now to heal millions upon millions of elementals in the earth. This I decree in the name of my own Christhood, in the name of my own becoming, the ascended master who I shall be and who I am already. For the seed is within itself, and the seed of my mighty I Am Presence is with me in my heart, and therefore I dedicate those percentages allowed me by the Lords of Karma of the fire of my life stream to the liberation of all elemental life. This I do in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit and of the Universal Divine Mother, and I accept it on this hour in full power by the blessing of the Lords of Karma. Amen. This call is so needed, beloved ones, that I ask you to make stickers that you can put on your doors, in your cars, on your mirrors, wherever you go to regularly. And when you see that sticker with that prayer, take a moment and say it, and know that all elemental life shall bless you. And that by giving this call and offering the fire of your beings, as the Lord Jesus Christ has offered the resurrection flame to elemental life, you will be raising them up. You will be involved in an interaction which shall become a mighty figure eight flow. And because you give this prayer frequently, it shall become a part of your own oneness with the great Antakarana of the cosmos, whereby you strengthen that Antakarana by the ashram rituals. So your blessing to elemental life shall prosper and move throughout the earth. And when all elementals of its earth have been raised up by the light bearers who have become their shepherds, so the mantra shall vibrate and quiver in many planes of being on other planets, where the elementals have been so trodden upon, have become so bowed down, that they actually passed from the screen of life. And where you see barren planets, where there is nothing there, as science reports it, beloved ones, in the physical octave, the elementals simply could not survive there because they had no sponsorship, not one single solitary son or daughter of God who remained on those planets. This is the cause, beloved. And when you look at the blessedness and the beauty of planet Earth and the violations of planet Earth, you realize, certainly with your eyes wide open, what precisely does hang in the balance. So, beloved, I cannot even tell you what great good karma shall come to you for caring for elemental life. Nor can I even begin to express the gratitude of elementals if you should give this mantra regularly in their behalf. For they will come and serve you and minister unto you. And as they do this, you shall come into their auras, and you shall bring them into your auras, and you shall teach them the violet flame, and you shall show them the way of giving the violet flame decrees, until by those very decrees they will become part of a universal alchemy, whereby the Son of God shall determine, as we all pray, that these elementals shall receive the gift of the threefold flame. And what a glorious day this shall be. For do you understand, beloved, that in these three kingdoms all are necessary in the earth? And so if all elementals have a threefold flame and are polarized to the cosmic Christ, Lord Maitreya, through the heart of Jesus and Padmasambhava, these elementals then can be a mighty presence in the sustaining of a great golden age. And what rejoicing, what gladness, what realization in your hearts that they too may then earn their immortal life, just as you are earning your immortal life by the same power of the heart flame. To this then I dedicate my portion of the conference, and I place your attention on this subject as a part of the time allotted to me to be upon this altar. Now, beloved ones, you have seen the gross misuses of atomic energy all over the world, and you have seen this since the earliest manifestations of the atomic bomb used in 1945. Yes, beloved ones, the misuses of atomic energy, nuclear energy, every form of energy, every form of the nucleus of the atom as it is applied, these misuses are what is causing not only the corruption of the earth body and all types of toxic wastes and all types of elements in the sea, in the earth, from underground testing, in the atmosphere. And you begin to reckon the half-life of these elements and you realize, how can the earth possibly be cleared and cleansed? Well, I will tell you. It is because the elementals will work with the sons and daughters of God and all who live upon this planet. It is because the elementals can join forces with the angelic hosts, because you offer this prayer for them, and this becomes a mighty equilateral triangle, even as the Trinity of Father, Son, and Holy Spirit is that equilateral triangle. So you may understand that the mighty action of the sacred fire of the Holy Spirit that does succor elemental life is a very part of the fire that they also have access to. So, beloved ones, as beloved Arcturus and Victoria have spoken, and all masters of the violet flame and the seventh ray since the beginning of the original dispensation of Saint Germain, releasing that flame in this century, that violet flame is the key to the restoration of this planet, to the healing of all your ailments, to your supply and the multiplication thereof. It simply requires more use and momentum and a fervor in your heart that knows that this is the promise of God, it will not be denied to anyone, not to sinner, not to the lowest form of life that you might not even deign to speak to. There is no one in the earth, no matter what classification, no matter what crimes they have committed, no matter how they have sinned against God or elemental life or the animal kingdom, there is no one who cannot come in to his own God realization by the persistent use of the violet flame, no matter how gross the violations of the law of God. If that one turn around and face the fire of the central sun and give those decrees daily, he will accomplish the purification and the neutralization of the negative forces of his being and become a positive force in the earth. This is the message I ask you to carry to every poor lost soul, every drug addict, everyone who is so imbalanced that they cannot even put the forces of their mind together to repeat the simple mantra, I am a being of violet fire. I am the purity God desires. Well, I say, beloved ones, do not fail to go after every part of life. And when someone asks you a question about how it is that you have this light or a book you are reading, do not fail to take the opportunity of giving a simple explanation of the teaching of the violet flame. Then this is the solution to the problem of the environment on earth today. Beloved ones, do you know that the violet flame used with intensity, especially in that 48-hour cycle with Omritas, will rid from the earth noxious weeds, poisonous substances, the insects that are biting and stinging and that are causing all kinds of diseases in the people, viruses at the level of the bodies of the people and the entire evolution of the planet, all forms of dread diseases that are in the earth that people acquire because they are imbalanced, because they do not have the fire built and banked within their heart chakra to throw them off. Blessed ones, there is such an outcropping of disease in the earth that has been contrived and manufactured long ago in the laboratories of other civilizations and continents such as Atlantis and Lemuria. And because the earth is at such a low level of vibration in the consciousness of many of the people, but not all, but surely the vast majority of the people, and there is therefore a lowering into the physical octave of the astral plane, all these manifestations that make human life almost impossible to live and to live to its fullest. This is what the violet flame will clean up. And I tell you, when you invoke the elementals to join with the seventh ray beings and all beings on all rays, for there is no one in heaven that does not use the violet flame, you will see the purification once again of the atmosphere of the earth. You will see the sealing once again of the astral plane, that it may no longer erupt into the physical. There is much to be cleaned up by that time, and my presentation to you this night is not intended to be an overstatement or an understatement, but the reality that when the violet flame is multiplied by you, great transformations will come about in your own brain, your mind, your body. You will feel the strength of rejuvenation as the flame within your heart becomes such a focus of violet fire that your threefold flame is continually multiplying that action, rippling through the waters, the air, and the earth. Blessed ones, you have not heard a single solution from scientists, environmentalists, governmental officials, name whatever category of person you would name, not a single solitary solution that will meet in time the crisis that we find in planet Earth today. The only solution is the God solution of the seventh ray of Aquarius, the seventh ray of the seventh age of Saint Germain and Portia. I ask you to welcome Saint Germain and Portia this night, who are overshadowing this conference. Beloved ones, mankind are being drawn as a shepherd draws his sheep toward the spiritual solution, not because they necessarily desire the spiritual solution, but because all other options are evaporating. This is the reason. Can you visualize the Great Pyramid? The Great Pyramid that is the thought form for alchemists, for supply, and for the rising of the soul to the capstone. Think of this pyramid superimposed over the entire earth and the earth inside it. Then see the masses of the people who have least development of the brain or of any God potential at the very base of the pyramid. Then see those who are awakening, who have some spiritual reality, a greater quickening of the mind, and as you go up, a greater quickening of the chakras, and then a level of purification until ultimately those who are the spiritual force that does yet hold the planet together are those who occupy the capstone of the pyramid because they have raised their energies to the point of the all-seeing eye of God. So you see, beloved, the space becomes narrower and narrower, and the greater spiritualization of consciousness, the less time and space does the individual occupy. So what do we find? Those who arrive at the capstone understand that the spiritual solution is the only solution, because in order to attain eternal life, they understand that they must pass through the point. And there is no time or space left in that point, and only one can pass through, and it is the one who has gone through the process of etherealization and then spiritualization. So now see, beloved, there is not a cure for cancer. There is not a cure for this. There is not a cure for that. And so those who contain a deep desire to survive, those who are the true survivalists, who are determined to make it, to realize their reason for being, and to get to that place where they came from, where God is. Those ones begin to feel that they have about them this pyramid that is narrowing, and in order to fit in that increasingly narrow space, they must let go of this three-dimensional world and enter in to that same spiritualization. Now, beloved ones, there is another kind of individual who also awakens to this realization that God is bringing all and raising all up in this formation, and they want no part of it, so they pull in the other direction. And they find ways and means to get out from under this pyramid, to go thither and yon, and to escape like rats escaping a sinking ship, except they are the sinking ship. Yes, beloved, there is a dividing of the way, and the determined ones who have chosen life in obedience to the message of Moses, they shall have that everlasting life. But I promise you, you will have to live every day of the rest of your life and put those hours toward that goal if you are to achieve the ascension. It is not automatic. And the more you rise in the pyramid, the more you are challenged by adepts of the left-handed path who have their counterfeit pyramid, and therefore they seek to unseat you. This path is for those who understand the subtleties of evil and the subtleties of the light and its gradations. How easily those who leave the path descend in vibration until that vibration becomes so tenuous and so attenuated that they can no longer hold a positive state of mind regarding Maitreya or his mystery school or his messenger. They cannot hold it. And so things begin to crumble and they turn to the negative side. And the negative side is bitterness, cowardice. It is contempt. Thus, beloved ones, You must sustain a tight and fiery coil and understand that this temple is a temple of living fire, and the living fire is your God, and your God in you can hold you to that central core as long as you have the balance of the great Tao, of the yin and the yang. God is the yang fire in the center, and you must build your life, your being, your consciousness around that fire, and not shoot out this way and that way so you are at distant Pluto or even another solar system. It is too far. You do not have the mastery to sustain such great breaths of being. You must become the concentrated one, concentrated on your assignment and that which you must accomplish. Staying close to home and close to your altar, and may that altar be wherever you abide, anywhere on earth. So we, the elementals, respect this altar in this configuration, and it is this altar of God where we go to pray and also place our fire. It consists of the chart of the presence of beloved Saint Germain, the Lord Jesus Christ, the Lord El Moria, the Lord Kuthumi, and such other saints and focuses and statues of those whom you know for certain are ascended masters. It also bears the photographs of the two witnesses who hold the balance for you, one on this side of the river and the other on the other side of the river. So it is true, beloved, there is a holding of the balance in that figure eight, as in heaven, so on earth, of your two messengers, and of this you should be certain to take advantage of their mission while it is alive and charging and thriving in the earth, for this is the open door, this is the way of your victory in the earth on behalf of all its evolutions, and your victory to your ascension. I, Oromasis, say to you, call to me frequently, for remember, I am not just an elemental, I am an ascended master. My consort, Diana, is an ascended master. We then together may be called upon just as you call to any other ascended master, and we have the combined momentum of having been inspired by Elohim with the responsibility of all fiery salamanders upon this planet. So call then for what? Call for the fire of the rainbow rays of God, which is soothing, healing, balancing, to transmute all and everything, anywhere, in your households, your communities, and on the entire planet. Again, beloved, become accustomed to the quick call and the fiery thrust and the use of the sword. Daily clear your households with Archangel Michael's sword. You need it, beloved, for wherever you are in light, wherever you have an altar of God and give your decrees, the fallen ones will come to tear it down. Thus go about the house with your frankincense and with your swords and make those fiats and see that you have nothing in the house that does offend your Lord Moria El, who is offended when you use such loud colors that attract the lower spirits when it is totally unnecessary. I speak of the bright reds and red oranges and the chartreuses and those colors that violate the seven rainbow rays of God and the five secret rays. This is not something cute that the messenger Mark Prophet invented 30 years ago. This is the law of the brotherhood. You will not find in any etheric retreat where you go such colors that allow in the forces that are beneath the earth in the depths of death and hell. No, you will not find them. Well, strive to make your homes as nearly close to the etheric retreats of the brotherhood as you can make them, at least with the colors that you have, and at least with the abundance that you are able to put together to make this place a home for Jesus and his disciples. Follow the basic teachings, beloved. They will carry you and carry you in strength and swiftly to your goal each day. You shall know the intensity of the fiery salamanders and of us, for we remain, and we remain with you. And if you will have us, you will now have, to the conclusion of this conference at midnight tomorrow night, a salamander superimposed upon you for the consuming and the transmutation of those levels of animal magnetism that make you, in spite of yourself, be somehow the instrument of something that is not good, something that comes through you because of a point within your being that has not been consumed by the sacred fire. Therefore, beloved, I ask that you conclude this service this night by reciting the call to the sacred fire breath. As you recite this call, then, my salamanders will one by one take up their place in your aura. I urge you to accept their gift, for they will not cause you any displeasure or pain except that which you invoke, if you should like a most accelerated action of the rainbow fire of God to assist you in your healing and in the clarification of your consciousness, which often does become cloudy. Now, beloved, I have spoken long enough, and therefore I ask you to speak by giving this decree. All of the love of cosmos be upon you, and I speak of mighty cosmos and his five secret rays, for he does continually bless our elemental bands with the action of his five secret rays. In the name of the five Dhyani Buddhas, the Buddha of the ruby ray, in the name of the Bodhisattva and the great Buddha Avalokiteshvara Kuan Yin, in the name of all hosts of the Lord, we serve. Decree 101, call to the fire breath. I am
the fire breath of God from the heart of beloved Alpha and Omega. This day I am the immaculate concept in expression everywhere I move. Now I am full of joy, for now I am the full expression of divine love. My beloved I am presence, seal me now within the very heart of the expanding fire breath of God. Let its purity, wholeness, and love manifest everywhere I am today and forever. I am the fire breath of God from the heart of beloved Alpha and Omega. This day I am the immaculate concept in expression everywhere I move. Now I am full of joy, for now I am the full expression of divine love. My beloved I am presence, seal me now within the very heart of the expanding fire breath of God. Let its purity, wholeness, and love manifest everywhere I am today and forever. I am the fire breath of God from the heart of beloved Alpha and Omega.
This day I am the immaculate concept in expression everywhere I move.
Now I am full of joy, for now I am the full expression of divine love. My beloved I am presence, seal me now within the very heart of the expanding fire breath of God. Let its purity, wholeness, and love manifest everywhere I am today and forever. I accept this done right now with full power. I am this done right now with full power. I am God life expressing perfection always at all times. This which I call forth for myself, I call forth for every man, woman, and child on this planet.
Surely it is such a tremendous experience to be in the presence of such beings who are so determined, who are so omnipotent in God, and have the action of the fire perpetually. What a rejoicing and a gift to hear from Oromasis and Diana.